Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today I wanted to do a get ready with me video slash tutorial on the Supernova palette that I have gotten from Bad Habit Beauty, which I got from Shop Hush. Now if you've seen my mini US haul, you would have seen I got this about maybe 2 weeks ago, or at least by the time that you see this video, it would be about 3 weeks already. Anyway, I wanted to do a get ready with me video for you guys, and this is the look that I created. I'm hoping that you're gonna like it. So if you wanna see how I created this look, then please keep on watching. So welcome to my bedroom. I don't have anything else on my face right now except for my eyebrows, my lash extensions, and my lip balm. I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pomade in dark brown for my eyebrows, and my lip balm is the L'Occitane Ultra Rich Lip Balm. I should have actually primed my lids already prior to turning on the camera, but as you know, I'm a little bit forgetful lately. Okay, so I'm using the Milani, what's it called, eyeshadow primer. I use that when I know that I'm not gonna really have a long day of being outside. It is currently autumn here in Australia. It's the reverse of the northern hemisphere, while the rest of the world is probably experiencing summer. We are at the tail end of winter. Autumn. So anyway, I've primed my lids. I'm going to be using the Bad Habit Supernova palette, as I've already previously mentioned. I just love the shades in here. And I specifically bought this for this bluish purple shade right there. But I've actually really been loving the Red Giant and Nebula as well. And even the Aurora shade right here is gorgeous. Like, I'm gonna insert some swatches here so that you can see what it looks like, but it's gorgeous. Anyway, I'm gonna start off with my eyes because some of these are quite powdery products and some of them really do have fallout. I'm also gonna be using my Stila Glitter and Glow liquid eyeshadow, and this is in the colors Smoldering Satin, because I'm thinking, let's see, a little bit of a cool toned vibe for this look. So I'm gonna start off with some brow bone highlight, and I'm using Sirius. This reminds me of Harry Potter, Sirius Black right there, and you can see my camera. Okay, so there, I'm using that, and this is a metallic sort of look, I would say satiny shade, but I just love how it highlights the brow bone. As you can see, what I'll be doing is do one eye and then do the other eye off camera, just so we can save some time. But look at that highlight. All right, that was, by the way, my Sigma E35 brush. And then I'm going to go in with the GRWM tool 776, which is like a, I don't know how you can, it's already splayed out. I don't like these GRWM brushes. I mean, seriously. I think I'm going to go in with a little bit of Celestial here, which is a matte sort of purplish brown shade. Don't know how else to describe it. Just to put that at the outer corners, sort of creating a little bit of depth there. I hope you're seeing that properly. Okay. I'm now going to take the base shadow brush from Real Techniques, and I'm going to go in with Red Giant. I'm Now, this particular shade, Red Giant, isn't really that glittery, so I can actually bring it up to the crease and use that as my crease shade. Go back again with Celestial. And then I'm going to go in with the Glitter and Glow Satin Taupe. I'm going to let that dry. Okay, so I've done the other eye as well, but it's not a final thing. I've also put on my my base, and I've got the Becca highlighting trio. I swiped each one in the back of my hand and then mix it with my Estee Lauder Perfectionist. I am in the color 4N1 shell beige, so that's what you're seeing. The glowy look on my face, and I've also put on my under eye concealer, brighteners, whatever, and it is the Maybelline Fit Me in number 25 medium, so that's that glow. I'm gonna powder that underneath later on, but what I'm gonna do now is I'm actually gonna continue with the eyes, and I'm gonna take this Andromeda shade here, the beautiful blue that I am obsessing over, and I'm gonna actually swatch this, bring it to the inglot shop and find an inglot version of this color, because I'm pretty sure they have it with the array of colors that they have. Anyway, I'm bringing this Andromeda shade at the bottom lash line. Yeah, so with the array of colors that Inglot has, I'm pretty sure I'll find something very, very similar, if not the exact same shade. And they have a lot of product in their pan, so I'm pretty sure that I'm going to be set. There we go. I love that. And I also do have this Royal shade of the Smashbox Always Sharp Waterproof Curl Liner. That self sharpening, I don't know how it does that, but it does it. I'm gonna bring that at the lower lash line as well. There you go. Now, obviously, I'm not going to be putting on any mascara on the top, but I'm going to put my YSL, what is this called? Mascara Volume. This is just a deluxe sample. I'm going to bring that the lower lash line. Not that I have much lashes to coat anyway. Ooh, the sun's shining really bright. Okay, now I'm gonna set my face. Might have to close the blinds a little bit. There you go. And this is the Tarte Smooth Operator setting powder. Just bring that at the bottom underneath my eyes to remove that extra glow and set that concealer. And it's also going to help blend out that shade that I put on the lower lash line. This Sigma F45 keeps on shedding. Blot my forehead as well, because that's always shiny. What? Mr. Sun. Oh, that's too much. Okay, there you go. I do enjoy that the sun is out because it's quite cold outside. I mean, I woke up at 11 degrees. Now it's time to contour my face. As usual, it's the Lorac Pro Contour Palette, and I always use the medium. And this has become one of my favorite brushes. This is the Zoeva Luxe Face Paint 109 from the Rose Gold Collection. And I use this, obviously, to bring out cheekbones that I don't have. Okay. I'm going to be using my, where is that thing? Bare Minerals highlighter. And this is Pure Radiance. Just going to make sure that there's not much on the cap. Take that same brush that I used to it's probably not showing much because there's no light, but later when I open the blinds a little bit, I'll show you how that looks. Any excess, I'll be putting down the bridge of my nose. I'm thinking if I should use eyeliner, but I'm not sure because I don't know how to remove that later on, because I'm not supposed to be using oily products. Oil-based products to remove my makeup because of my lash extensions. Now this one I just discovered yesterday. This is the Petal Metal Highlighter from Smashbox, and this is in the color Rosemantic. I mean, how gorgeous is that packaging? But I've actually tried to use it as a shimmery blush, and it actually worked. I'm gonna take my Real Techniques blush brush. Now this one doesn't pick up that much color, so that's why I think it's perfect. And I'm gonna swipe that on an upward motion. I probably don't even need highlighter when I'm using this. Can you guys see how gorgeous that is? Okay, and then the final step would be lips, and I will be using, what will I be using? I think I'm going to go with my ColourPop Dopey shade. There you go. And that's the finished look. So yeah, that's the look. Vogue. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Let me know in the comment section down below if you enjoy watching these kinds of videos. I can do it more often, but I'm telling you, I don't have a massive makeup collection and I don't get the latest products all the time. So if you're looking for tutorials on the latest palettes, it's probably not going to be on this channel. Anyway, yeah, so I hope you enjoy that. Subscribe if you haven't already, like I said. Hit that notification bell so that you are updated on when I post videos, which is usually Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. All right? I'll see you all again in the next one. Bye!